Alright. We're gonna give this DLC a shot here. Let's see. Specter of Torment, eh? Yep. Yep. That fits. There once was a land called One Piece. I did that wrong. So they're gonna. He built the team. Is that it? That's not suspicious at all. How are we gonna justify every boss fighting every other boss? The next DLC is for the iceberg guy, and the story is that he has to forcefully give everyone snow cones. No immediate retreat this time. All running. Use your shot, your scythe, to dig. I mean, it makes sense, it's still a farming tool. I got a darkness meter. Oh, can you not run up? While I'm here and I'm safe to test it. Okay, you will repeatedly wall run, but you have a limited distance. Alright. Skulls for the skull throw. Is that just me being on it? I think so. Okay, you hit it and you keep going. Alright. Trying to tank it out from the beginning is to revenge your ammo. It'll help you guys. Ooh. Okay, if you're in the air, you wanna. Okay, jump the automatic. Okay. Okay. He automatically pops platforms when he drops on them.
Okay.
He can air dash the bubbles, but he only gets one shot.
Robot. Push buttons around enemies because I can end up eat the dead. The turkeys of the dead.
Okay. Ah, so that's probably gonna be something familiar too. I can't... Noted. You can swoosh through the bubbles, but you cannot directly land on them. I guess that makes sense, because that's exactly how it was for Trove himself.
Got some of it back.
Oops, I get it. Gotta wait till I land completely.
No magic.
Oh yeah, that's right. Is this one here?
Okay. Souls.
Careful about expecting when the wall run. Pogoing, but even more effective since you kind of got like a lock on for it. Now I have to figure out, maybe there's a way to control it where if you're falling down, you can go up. Let's see. might just be you always head down. Yeah, you always head down and run down the middle. You always head up and run up where I go. So let's see, you go with us. Maybe I have to wait till he's higher up.
That might be why.
Ah, no dirt for this time. Fast, I get it. And then go jump off the ladder and go back really fast. He only lives to 2 slashes though, right? That's embarrassing. Oh man. Just. Alright, let me prep for this jump. If I prep for this jump, I mean just step off the ledge and kill myself. Patience, what am I doing? What a patience. Oh, I guess I should have. Well, that was dumb. Chugger could have eaten that fruit. Okay. So I have to come across her specifically on the upway. But it still changes when you I got too close to it too quick. And it changes you at the last second. Oh, that's gonna take some getting used to. Wish you could control whether you went up or not. That would've made things a lot easier. I guess that would've made it too easy though, because then you would always be guaranteed to do it the right way. Why would you ever want to... Why would you ever want to slash up on a falling opponent, I guess? There we go. Now the question is can I get across that? Okay, cool, he respawns. I'm just gonna go without the money and just settle on having the cool skull. More important to me right now. Oh no!
This is stage one.
I like it. I like the challenge.
At least what you got is going to happen. So
you don't have to be like, oh no, I gotta fool around for that. Right into the ground. Off a cliff. Money is not my concern here. Not dying embarrassingly is my concern, but you wouldn't be able to tell from the way I'm playing right now. Entry hits for practice. Practice hits. Timing here is pretty much guaranteed to kill you. It's not like you just be like, oh, I bounced off of him, shovel style, and this time the shovel bounce. I can just quirk myself and try it again. Just, if you mess it up, you go from going up to going down, and that's it. You're just gonna shoot yourself downward instead of upward, and it's gonna kill you no matter what you do. Thank you.
least I have rotten chicken.
So wherever Black Knight is from, the average commoner is a fully plated, cloaked man with a giant scythe. That's what the average Joe looks like. Spiked Rhino. I get it, because otherwise it would just be me air dashing the crap out of him. Okay, yeah, you just have to hard jump the projectiles. That's something I should have tested to show if I could flip projectiles back in Specter of Torment, and yes, you can. So that's something to keep in mind. I don't know if being an undead Scythe Knight is exactly safe. Is this our dream sequences? Scientists. Healing. Range projectiles. Close range strikes. We'll go with,
Darkness a man keep free.
I think it's a good stopping point for now. Finish exploring there. Oh no, I actually gotta find a safe thing first, don't I? Sure there's something for that. Fun so far. Gonna go enjoy the rest of the adventures later on. Hopefully you'll be able to come back later and enjoy them with me.